So far we have learned creating a user interface form. We have also learned server side validation. We also learned how to place these portions independently. This label, this text box, its validation messages. But what we have missed so far is the client side validation. This validation will occur in the browser through JavaScript. And definitely it will be more responsive because there will be no time lag between the data that will be first posted to the server and then wait for the validation to occur. This validation will be instant. And let us see how to do it now. This is our UI form that we have made so far. The username story, the phone number. The validation here implements the annotations made on the model. But this implementation is occurring entirely at the server side. Now our job is to ensure that these rules are implemented on the client side also. For this, we shall have to go to our layout file and include the necessary jQuery JavaScript files first. This is our layout file that we have at present. This marks the title. This renders the CSS. This adds the bundles for modernizer. This modernizer is not related to our validation. You will have to do extra study for this. It is a third party library that you can use to increase your knowledge, but you'll have to refer to third party sources. There is a separate dedicated website for modernizer. Another thing that I would like to tell you here is about Knockout.js also. There is a similar library called Knockout. This is not part of this course. You will have to do an independent study about these. So at present, coming back to this, this is our render body tag. This includes all the jQuery bundles. This is a section on scripts that you can mark in your layout if you have certain special scripts that you want to be included. If you have a plugin and you want to include its scripts only on that layout, only on that view page, then you can mark this section. Then you can use this render section and mark that section as scripts. So let me first clear about these doubts. Consider this screen. Suppose you have a view, and on this view I am using a plugin, a jQuery plugin. This plugin is shown only on this view, and it is having its own script includes. Now definitely we don't want this script include to be done on all the views. We want these to appear only if this view is rendered. So there is no point in putting this src in the layout file. by including src tags here. In a big site, in a big website, there might be so many plugins on so many different pages. So unnecessarily including so many source files will definitely slow down the download speed of your page. So why not include them in the view only and mark it as a special section, so that that section gets rendered if it is present in a view. So you can write @ section, give it a name scripts, and put whatever scripts you want in this. And there is a render section tag on the layout. So this one will appear only if it is marked in a view. So this junk will be avoided. When this view is called for and it has a section called scripts, then the script tags here will only be rendered in the layout because of this, and it is marked required false in case it is not there on a view page, then this line will be ignored. Okay, now coming to this, what jQuery files are to be included for validation? MVC already includes a bundle for you. We have a bundle here, render bundles by modernizer. We have a bundle called bundles by jQuery. There are other bundles which have been included for us. We can make use of them. Let us see what are they. Go to your solution explorer. In the app start you will find bundle config. Double click it. The first that is available to us is the include for the jQuery. It is appropriately named bundles by jQuery. This hyphen version means the correct version will be included here. This is a wildcard. Special meaning for MVC files. Similarly, you have a script bundle for jQuery UI. Here also version wildcard is used. So in case you need to use widgets, then this one is available to you. Then there is one more that is available, jQuery val. Val means validation. And here it says include all files which have names starting with jQuery.unobtrusive star and jQuery.validate star. So this will include all the necessary client-side validation files for AJAX validation as well as for the normal validation. We can have a look at the Solution Explorer to see what all these files could be. Here is the Solution Explorer, and let us come down, pin it here and scroll it this way. Scripts by jQuery dot unobtrusive. So this is the list that is available. Unobtrusive hyphen AJAX. So this one will catch these two files, and this one will catch these files. These VS Doc are for IntelliSense. So we have to include this bundle into our layout file first. Coming back to here. So remember its name, copy its name it is, and we can place it right before the jQuery bundle. scripts dot render and paste it here. So with this, our jQuery client-side validation files are in place. This alone is not sufficient. We have to write a command here to enable client-side validation specifically. If we don't write it, it won't be enabled. So we'll write here @HTML dot unobtrusive JavaScript enabled is equal to true. This is one. The other is so when we write these two lines, the client-side validation gets enabled. You don't have to write any other line of code. The same code what you wrote here, it keeps working. This one is the only required change here. The rules implemented, the rules written inside your model, they will be implemented now on the client side also. Let us run it and see it. Click on save and no postback occurred. And you can see as I type, this message vanished. So it is occurring on the client side. Type a wrong phone number, it says valid phone. It's very responsive rather. So now you can click on save and it works. So you just have to include the proper bundles for jQuery well, which are already written for you by the Visual Studio. And you have to put these two lines in place. Doing this, your client-side validation is enabled.